Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install the current Eclipse version. To install Eclipse, we don't need Java because Java comes pre-installed with the current Eclipse version. At first, go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any web browser. Herein type Eclipse and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible, eclipse.org. Click on it. It will directly take you to the following link. The following link, that is the download link. Here in the Eclipse version is visible, go below. Here it is, the current version. Okay, click download to download it. Now here and click download to finally begin the download. The exe file will download. Download started, it's only 124 MB, let's wait. Download completed, double click on it to install, minimize. The download started, the first one is for Java developers. Below, when you will go, the Eclipse for C, C++ is visible, and this is for PHP developers, but we want for Java, so I'll be going for the following. Click on it to install Eclipse for Java. Herein you can see it automatically took the Java version. This is what I told you. So I'll go for the recent one, which is supported by this Eclipse version, and Eclipse will get installed in the following location. No problem. It will also create a startup menu as well as a desktop icon. Here it is. Keep it as it is. And I'll just click on install here. Accept the agreement. Now the installation begins. Let's wait for a few seconds. Installation completed successfully. Click launch to launch it, and it also created a desktop shortcut. I'll click launch. So you need to add a workspace. So workspace is a place wherein all your project files, plugins will get saved. Keep it as it is. Okay, you can keep this as default so that it won't ask you again whenever you'll create a new project. Click launch. Eclipse started for the first time. Now we can directly create a Java project from here, or we can go to file and go to new and click on Java project. Now add the name of the Java project. Let's say I'll add Amit application. The location is the default. I told you all the projects will get saved under the workspace, and it went to the workspace only. Keep rest as it is. Java 20 it will take, and here you don't need a module info for a basic project. Click next. Click finish. That's it. It will create a new Java project. Here it is. Now we need to create our first class file. So right click. Go to new. Click on Java class. That is class. Herein add a package name. Let's say I'll add com.studiopedia. Name of the class file. Let's say I'll add demo, and for rest I'll just go for the basic public static void main and click finish. Now it will create a demo.java file. Here it is with a sample code. Herein you can see the class file is the same, and the file name is the same. So this is how a Java program works. If both are different, there will be an error. Package, I told you com.studiopedia.com. I added this, so it went in com.studiopedia. Now let us print something quickly. So you can add any text you want to print. So I added the following. Okay. Now go to file, save all. Now let us quickly run it. Go to run, click on run as and the Java application, click on it. Now it will run. You can see whatever we wanted we printed successfully. Amit thinks printed, so we added the following under println method to print it. So guys, in this video we saw how we can easily download and install the current Eclipse version and run our first Java project also. Thank you for watching the video.